everybody, welcome back to Northern Lions Challenge Runs in the Binding of Isaac. I got an interesting run today from YouTube user Nova Stador, and I'm pretty sure it's like N-O-V-E-S-T-A-D-O-R. I'm pretty sure I've seen him before in another challenge run suggestion. So this is just called Troll Engine, and there's an interesting kind of concept behind this. We have a lot of items that have kind of randomized effects. So we have Rainbow Baby, which obviously has a randomized tier effect on every single shot from one familiar. We have $3 bill, which gives us a random tier effect on every room. I believe we have spectral tiers right now. And we have Book of Sin with infinite item power. I'm not going to take any of these, by the way. I just wanted to demonstrate that we do have infinite item power. And the premise of this run is basically Troll Engine got fed up with me being like, oh, fucking Troll Engine, oh, bullshit, like blaming it for my failures all the time. So it took things into its own hand, and it's going to completely control the outcome of this run. So we're only allowed to use Book of Sin once per room, otherwise that would be, we could just abuse that to basically get as many keys and bombs as we wanted and roll like a straight bomb run or something. But other than that, there's basically no restrictions. We can take whatever items we want as long as they don't change our tier effects beyond recognizability, basically. So I'm interested to see how this works out. I think this is a fairly well-balanced run. We start with a little bit of an advantage, I would say, over usual, because we are going to be able to use the Book of Sin once per room. Rainbow Baby is a solid item, and what was the other one that I was going to talk about? $3 bill occasionally has the ability to be good. It also has the ability to be terrible, though, depending on what kind of effects we get in certain kind of situations. For example, my reflection combined with an Ipecac. That's the classic, like, trademark example. But we're definitely going to be high on consumables here. I do not want Kamikaze. I guess that would be the other condition, is that you can't get rid of the spacebar item. And I'm going to say that I can only use the Book of Sin on enemy rooms. Otherwise, I could have just used it on the item room right there. But in any case, if I end up messing that up a time or two, don't get too mad at me. Believe me, I'm not doing it maliciously. Merely trying to do the best of my ability to stay within the realm of the challenge run here. We're going to be fighting Steven. This is great. I would absolutely love to get a damage upgrade or another familiar. That's fine, too. I'm always wary about getting familiars now, though, because there is always the chance that we can get, like, five of them. And then it wouldn't work anymore. Although, I guess it's pretty unlikely that we're going to get five familiars. We definitely need to get Chad, because that's like an obvious one. Gish would be another one that would have to show up. Trying to think about who else. Like, Brother Bobby and Sister Maggie typically only come from deals with the devil or the occasional item room or like a fight against the fallen, so it's pretty unlikely. Yeah, we're probably fine. It's only when you start yourself with like two or three familiars that you put yourself into a situation where maybe some of them are going to become obsolete. So we are going to get Little Steven. We are going to get a Spirit Heart and an Eternal Heart. That's a pretty wicked end to that floor. So we're going to head down to the basement part two. And things are going just peachy so far, so I'm not going to use Book of Sin on this room, but we're going to continue. So this is like a kind of a, it's like a vanilla run with pralines or something like that, if this is going to be an ice cream flavor. It's not quite a normal challenge run, and the Spirit Hearts are awesome here. But it's certainly not quite a vanilla run as well, because we're starting with a little bit of an advantage. Book of Sin is an item that I've kind of characterized as mostly useless. Like, it's one of those items where, what is going on with the Spirit Heart drops here? That's great. But it's kind of not been getting its due, I guess you could say, for me in recent videos. I typically just figure that, like, it's probably the worst book that you can possibly get. Unless, okay, something is just terribly wrong with the Troll Engine here, and I like it. I think it's probably the worst book, although I'm thinking now, maybe, no, Book of Belial's better, Book of Revelations is better. Book of Shadows is the only one that might not be better. I don't even think I used Book of Sin on that room, by the way, but I'm not going to backtrack. That seems a little bit chintzy. But yes, what I'm trying to get at is Book of Sin plus infinite item power is kind of a balancing factor for the fact that Book of Sin on its own is not really all that good, so we're going to be fighting regular Larry Jr. here. And you know what? The other dynamic that this changes that you might not have thought about at first, as I took some horrible damage there, is that now I'm a little bit more free to use bombs in combat, because we're likely going to pick up way more bombs than we normally do. I can't say that with certainty. We might just pick up a fuck ton of keys. However, I think that's how it's going to work for us. So I'm definitely going to take the range upgrade. I'm definitely going to pop Book of Sin and take the Emperor card. That's useful, you know, especially the longer I can save that. And you know what? Why not take the pact as well? Which is going to give us increased damage, and also some other stats up, I believe. I never actually looked into, like, the intricacies of the pact, or the specifics of the pact, I should say. I know it does give us a damage upgrade. I'm not sure what it gives us with respect to other stats. I feel like I'm the same speed. We should possibly use a bomb to check out what we got in here, but I guess it's not really worth the money in the whole scheme of things. We're obviously going to explore more because we want to go to the deal with, or the item room. We've already been to the deal with the devil room, Northern Lion. Make no mistake about that. The pact is one of those items that largely I consider fairly useless when it comes to deals with the devil. I like almost never like to take it, but considering there's a lot of deal with the devil items I do like to take that we cannot take this time, this seems like a smarter decision. So we're going to take Spelunker's hat, and that is going to be the end of this floor, although we will certainly find both secret rooms now, and possibly, you know, if I'm looking for good second secret rooms, the Eternal Heart room is probably my favorite. This one is probably the worst in our current situation, although it does benefit us sometimes. So Spelunker's hat, in combination with Infinite Book of Sin, is going to be awesome for us, because we're almost certainly going to have enough bombs to go to every secret room. This is going to allow us to go to some more shops, in all likelihood, and who knows, maybe we pick up, something that would make things more useful, like the ladder, maybe? Candle is obviously worthless, as is battery and the 9 volts. I don't know, man. We're gonna save our keys for now, because I don't think there's anything worthwhile in that shop, especially when we only have 9 cents. We'll just continue onwards then. I mean, there's always the chance for me to buy just keys. Oh, come on, don't get hit. Like keys and bombs in the shop, and pills and tarot cards, which are all useful in their own right. There's a secret room down here. Should remember to use Book of Sin as well, because if I start making mistakes with that, it'll add up, even though that one didn't do too much for us. We're just gonna get the hell out of here. Caves Part 1, usually a fairly reasonably sized floor, so I don't think we're gonna run into too much trouble with respect to... Oh, that's what I want to buy from the shop, compass. Alright, never mind. So we have a slowing or freezing effect. That's the number one $3 bill upgrade, in my personal opinion. It's the ability to get that red shot from, like, Mom's Contact, I think it is, which freezes the enemy. And is basically going to make our boss fight super easy. So first things first, yeah, we'll definitely use that. Free Spirit Heart. Trading a bomb for a key seems like a smart decision in our current situation. And we're going to be dealing with some flies down here, as well as some non-visual silkworms. Just trying out a new name there. It didn't really work out for the best, I would say. Alright, an extra bomb. Is there a second secret room coming up? It doesn't appear so. You know, we're strong enough right now where we don't have to go to the item room before we fight the boss. I always almost forgot how that was. Like, on vanilla runs, you almost always want to go to the item room before you fight the boss, unless you're feeling cocky. We're gonna check this pill, which teleported us far away. Well, now we might as well just explore as much as we can, because we're here. And my number one strategy in Isaac doesn't even relate to the game itself. I just like to minimize backtracking, because that speeds up the rate at which these runs happen, which is good for me, because I hate just walking around. It just feels like a waste of your time, right? Whereas, you know, recording 400 episodes of The Binding of Isaac, certainly not a waste of time. every joke there's a little bit of truth, but I'm only being half-joking there. Occasionally I get questions like, Northern Lion, what the fuck are you doing, man? 400 episodes of Isaac? What do you want me to do, Mom? This is what I want to do with the rest of my life. We have a shop there. And you know what? We're going to go to it because we're here anyway. We're going to use Book of Sin. That's going to give us the stars, which takes us to the secret room, so we don't really want that right now. Shop gives us a key and the battery, neither of which are really that useful. Now we got an interesting situation. I think we just get rid of the stars card. Take telepills straight into the item room, can't do anything with that, and that's basically gonna do it for Caves Part 1, although we do have another secret room, a library apparently, which is obviously 100% useless. There's nothing we can get out of that that would benefit us. But hopefully, death card. Alright, not terrible. We're using a lot of bombs here. I wish we got more bombs. Well, so far so good. And we're still rolling very well on Spirit Heart, so I can't really sweat my health right now either. And in here we have the red patch, which is gonna give us rage, but it's the rage that only works after you get hit, so I'm not sure if that's really that beneficial. I realize I am leaving some tarot cards, like I'm leaving the stars card. I could always backtrack for that, but I don't think it's worth it. Basically, the stars card is just gonna save you a bomb, which in our current iteration is not really that big of a deal. More tarot cards. Well, Hierophant, I will definitely never sigh as I say more tarot cards again. That's 2 free spirit hearts, which is going to be very beneficial for us. The half heart is worthless, but the death card, probably going to get good use out of on this boss fight, especially if we're fighting something that spawns a lot of enemies. For example, a fistula. I can just get fistula as low as possible, like as many iterations of the smaller fistula on screen. Then I'll leave, get the emperor card. Okay, that's how we're going to do this. Well, ask and ye shall receive. We are indeed going to be fighting little Chad. I always make that mistake here. We might as well just pop the death card basically as soon as possible. Whittle him down a little bit. That actually did a surprising amount of damage. The problem with this guy, of course, is that he gets faster and faster as time goes on. So we're just gonna try to keep our distance. Didn't really work out all that well, because now I'm right next to him and ended up taking damage. That's okay, though. He's gonna be dead fairly soon. We've only taken half a heart of damage. Of course, as an item, I feel like Chad is basically garbage. But, whatever. We gotta do what we gotta do. He is dead, and we are alive. Suck on that. Book of Sin is another heart. And we do have a deal with the devil. I could get permanent curse state here. Or just get, like, no, I can't, actually, because I can't get rid of my spacebar item. I could just get rid of my hearts for no reason, but that doesn't seem like a smart idea when I could use those for a deal with the devil later. Hopefully you guys are following that. Basically, the two items in there, I wouldn't get in a permanent curse state because I don't have Whore of Babylon, but I would be in a position where I could get permanent invincibility from the Polaroid. At some point, my nomenclature just becomes so kind of inclusive, or I guess exclusive to people who don't watch the videos, that I kind of wonder if I'm actually communicating effectively or if I'm just spouting off like buzzwords that I've sort of created. And that is utterly incomprehensible to someone who just tunes into the video for the first time. Luckily, if you're just tuning in for the first time, you're probably a rarity. I doubt too many people are like, oh yeah, episode like 384, that's where I want to start. I'm not sure what's going on with these conga liners. I just got stuck in the wall for a minute. But we're basically done with this room as soon as I get one more hit. And the bomb is ours, as is the key. That's exactly what I want out of Book of Sin. If they could just give me like a bomb and a key per room, I would be a very happy camper, because we are unlikely to use more than a bomb or a key per room, of course. Now, I would like some actually good items, excellent, from the item rooms. We haven't really lucked out with that so far. We're still in that kind of, like, interim phase where anything could happen with this run. I haven't really picked a set strategy. I would absolutely love to do, like, an all-spirit hearts run, but we're gonna need a better deal with the devil to make that happen, and ideally, the way I would like to make it work is like a Guppy's Paw trade, so we would need more HP to make that happen in the first place if we're gonna get a lot of them. So of course we get X-ray specs. Apparently, whenever we get Spelunker's Hat, we also get X-ray specs. Did I use? I think I did, but I'm gonna take the key anyway. If I did, that's totally my bad. So Spelunker's Helmet is now useless. That would be a good idea for a challenge run, but I need someone to draft it up because I can't think of it right now. It would be a run where, basically, did I already go to the secret room? I don't think so. I think I just abandoned it. I might not have even gone to the secret room on the last floor, which would be silly of me. A run where you only take, like, redundant items, although I don't know if that would work, because you can't take both Nail and Book of Revelations at the same time. And as many people have pointed out, I'm just using the Magician to get rid of it, basically. Deal with the Devil, or sorry, Book of Revelations and the Nail are not redundant. Like, the Nail is not a straight upgrade. Yes, stop sending me messages. I didn't misspeak, I just misthought. Of course there are situations where Book of Revelations is better if you're looking to get the cubes of meat. That was just a small oversight in my logic, which, you know, if you watch the videos, you should be more than used to by now. We're gonna see what we've got in this pill. Speed up, that's actually pretty useful. I was getting a little bit low on that. Starting to have trouble dodging. Now we do have 8 bombs. We could use those on this fight and make this much easier on ourselves. Instead, I'm gonna take damage while contemplating whether or not I should use them. He who hesitates masturbates, and I've found myself in that position right now. No, literally masturbating as we speak. But yeah, this is what I was thinking. This, the freezing effect is just going to make things easy on us regardless, so we should just do things that way. Especially if we can actually get this guy frozen. It only hits like 1 out of every 10 times, but there we go. That wasn't so bad. Mom's coin purse has the potential to be awesome or horrible for us, depending on whether these gold pills are good. Puberty? Well, they're not bad, but they're certainly not good. We do still have Book of Sin available on this floor, so telepills, and this one, come on. Bombs are key. Basically did nothing for us. We are going to telepill. I was just hoping, obviously, that that would take us to the I Am Error room, but we might as well go to the shop anyway. We've got the cash to support it, and we'll buy a Spirit Heart, and obviously Notched Axe is for the Boyds, so we're just going to skip over that and head down to the Depths Part 1. So far, so good, but this is a run where I don't like our future prospects. This is like a womb 1, womb 2 failure right now, in my opinion. But, you know, anything could happen. We do have that Emperor card, and if I can save that for as long as possible, I can use that to maybe skip over one of those womb floors and make things easier on myself. Possibly make it to the cathedral, if we're on the bright side of things. So we got the Unicorn Horn, which I can't take. And this item is really screwing me with respect to, like spacebar items that I can't use due to our challenge here. Alright, so I've used 2 bombs. Believe you me, I didn't like doing that. I kinda liked it because I did get to see like my least favorite enemy explode in a hail of brains. But apart from that, I wasn't really a big fan of it because, oh, I didn't even use Book of Sin. Alright, play it cool. You're starting to get a little out of sorts here. It's okay though, there we go, alright. So we're going to use Book of Sin here. I am going to go back because now I need to emphasize every possible advantage within the realm of the rules. It's just the Depths, which means there's going to be 2 item rooms and 2 bosses. This may actually work out in our favor. if we get through it, I mean, it's one of those things, it's gonna be hell to get through. But you know, as Winston Churchill said, if you're going through hell, keep going, and that's exactly what we're gonna do. Tears up, that's a good pill. I found pills, that's a pill, it's not a good pill necessarily, not to shit-talk the pharmacist or manufacturer who put it together, but why are you making pills that make people retarded? Is this some Jenny McCarthy shit right here? What am I even being hit by? There's like an invisible head somewhere in this room. That hardly seems fair. I had a feeling we would be fighting greed here. There's nothing we can do about it now. Again, I gotta use Book of Sin more. What am I thinking? Could be missing out on valuable spirit hearts here. This is very good. Thank you. Surprising use of Little Gish. And I got hit again, but somehow we're still doing okay on spirit hearts. But again, that can change drastically in a heartbeat. Book of Sin. Key. Not bad. But I am, again, going to use Book of Sin here. That's a pill that is not good for us, I think. Oh, that's a really good pill, actually. Totally my bad. We're just going to keep moving onwards here. I will open that golden chest, because, again, there's a possibility... Oh, we got triple shot in this room. There's a possibility that it's a stats upgrade, which I could really use right now, especially if it's HP. We're definitely going to blow this up. Use Book of Sin. Red Heart is not useful yet, but could very well be in the future. And we got another key and 2 cents as a result of that. Probably not a fair trade in the whole scheme of things, but that's okay. So I definitely want to destroy the leapers. Well, I mean, I want to destroy the bomb flies. Oh man, we have my reflection. When will my reflection go? That was deliberately nasal, but trust me, my regular singing voice is not much better than that in the first place. Go out to karaoke with your friends when I was in Korea, and I was just like, oh Ryan, come on, don't sing anymore. We have another spirit heart, fantastic. Sorry, I got lost in my own bad memories there. We have Fortune Teller here, which I am going to play. Sorry, I had a brain aneurysm there. We're going to play until we get down to like 20 cents. And I'm just going to watch out for the tick, because that is the worst thing we can come across right now. I mean, the only reason I'm picking 20 cents is kind of arbitrary. It's a rounded number. Sun card, sure. Does that beat the Emperor card? That's a very good question. And there's the Polaroid, which we might as well not take, to be honest with you. All right, here's the thing. We got the Sun card. That does beat the Emperor card. We could use the Emperor card, go fight the first boss of 2 here. And then, like, leave, come back, pick up the Sun card, use that. Because we need this as, like, basically a full health pill at some point. Although, considering we only have 2 red hearts, it's not really that beneficial. I don't know, but it also functions basically as a compass. It's a very difficult situation to call here. What I could do, and this might be the wrong way to do it, I'm thinking maybe we use the Sun card to find which way to go, and then we use the Emperor card after that, because I feel like, honestly, the Emperor card might actually be more valuable when you only have 2 red hearts. Like, what if we use... Okay, I'm just going to use it. I hate to do it. This shows us where we need to go, though, which is useful. We get another spirit heart. Awesome. And we find out that we were, like, absolutely nowhere near the boss, but we're already... this is the way we have to go, unfortunately. We're on the right track, I suppose. And we're going to take the... tarot card, but not the Polaroid. Well, it doesn't really matter. Red patch is going to be more beneficial for us, but this is a long trip to get to the boss room here. So I guess what I could do is just use the Emperor and skip over like the rest of the depths. But I kind of feel like I want to use the Emperor on the womb. Even though this is a huge floor, it's probably in our best interest to save this Emperor card and use it maybe on womb 1 or 2, whichever one we get Utero on, basically. Or... if possible, even save it on the cathedral. Save it for the cathedral, I should say. Now, what are my, like, main... if I was being optimistic, what am I looking out for on this run right now? I would absolutely love for an appearance of some judgments, because those are basically my only way of getting rid of this money in a valuable way. Oh, I knocked... the bullet knocked him into the path where he could hit me. That seems like nonsense, but it's exactly how that shit went down. We got Bomb Key and a bunch of red hearts. By way of Book of Sin, Little Chad, and just random drops on the room, of course. Oh, that was kind of close. I hate those turrets. I always mess up the dodge. Okay, what about this one? Speed up. Sure, I will absolutely take it. That was worth a half a spirit heart loss. This should be a fairly easy room. Oh, no, I'm just going to take damage. I was just about to say that I have no business taking damage on this room. Sadly. Sometimes, you know, I'm my own worst enemy when it comes to making comments like that that are going to make me eat crow, basically. So we are going to get 2 item rooms. These are going to be hugely important when it comes to determining our chances of success. As is the rest of my time on this room, to be honest with you. I am taking way, way too much damage and not feeling too positive about things. But hey, it's just mom and mom's heart. We got two spirit arts on the room randomly. Book of Sin is going to give us another speed up pill. All is not lost yet. And again, we're going to get some momentum after this. We're going to get an item from both bosses. So we're going to get like four items in the next 10 rooms. And then I can pop the Emperor card if I have to, fight the first boss on Utero or Womb 1, which is probably not going to be too difficult unless it's the bloat, especially if it's champion bloat. And we could possibly make a swing here. This is like some Apollo 13 shit. We don't know what this does. Health up would be awesome. Bad gas is at least not bad. I'll take it. Okay, so Fly Guy's got to die first. Brain Guys have got to die second. Oh, that was some awful damage. Should have just had a little bit more patience there. And, okay, Dead Sea Scrolls I cannot take, even though it is kind of in keeping with the randomness. I did use Book of Sin to make up for the fact that I didn't use it on that room before. And I'm just trying to keep you up to date on the play-by-play of what's going through the head of Northernlion right now. So we're going to take out these guys. Oh, come on. I love when they die or they go into the ooze state on the spike. That makes my job easier. And again, for health, we're doing okay, largely due to an unbelievably fantastic string of luck with respect to the Book of Sin giving us Spirit Hearts, which is not very likely. PhD is coming. We've gotten a lot of pills in this run. So this would have been more useful earlier, but at least it's an item from an item room that we can actually take for once. Because largely, we have spent a lot of time just being completely devoid of usefulness with respect to item rooms. It's okay. We've actually managed to clear out this room fairly well. Confident in my abilities to beat these two bosses without taking too much damage. Again, it does depend on what the bosses are. To a certain extent, at least. Like, we've run across, like, Bloat Fallen or something. I'm not even sure if you can get the bloat outside of the womb, but... you know, there's always the potential for things to go terribly wrong here, but... I think we're in a decent position, and we're gonna get two more items here! I did use Book of Sin there, yes. Alright, so Fallen was exactly what I did not want to run into, but we did get the freezing effect, which is pretty much the greatest luck I could possibly imagine right now. So with him splitting, might be worth using a bomb, but I don't want to just in case, because we're going to need these for the Mom's Heart boss fight, or possibly even, you know, the first boss fight on the womb. So this has been a fairly easy fight so far. We are going to get a deal with the devil item here. I don't want it to be Mom's Knife. I would actually love it to be maybe Guppy's Paw. Guppy's Tail is probably one of the worst items you could have gone with. But at least, again, it's an item we can take, and we pick up another bomb as a result of Book of Sin. Alright, Mom's Heart, or sorry, Mom's, you know, regular version of herself. And we are going to have the Spectral Tears for this fight, which is not nearly as good as Freezing, but at least it's Red Mom. Of course, Method Mom's rap partner. So I expect that this fight is going to go fairly well for us. Because we don't have to deal with any enemies. We have to deal with the occasional triple shot from the eye. I'm going to get hit by a lot of those just because I'm a terrible dodger. What if I just stand like a little off-center? Will it still shoot at me? And if so, could I not just dodge it by not moving? Maybe standing off-center is the seat. Nah, it still shoots at you. And it actually aims a little bit. But regardless, easy fight. We're just going to continue moving back and forth here. It's almost like a Monstro 2 boss fight. And he will be done, or she will be done, I guess, in like another one or two barrages. This one seems like it's going to do it. We get a health upgrade, which is very useful. I believe, it's stem cells, no, not meat, never mind. We're definitely gonna have to take the Polaroid, we're gonna use Book of Sin. It's gonna give us, the Moon card, but Emperor card is absolutely more valuable at this point. So we're going down to the Womb Par 1. What was, oh, I didn't mean to do that, I'm not gonna take it. What was my prediction for this run? I believe I mentioned, the likelihood of a womb, oh, come on. I can't believe I didn't get hit there. The likelihood of a womb failure. I think that's still probably where we're gonna end up here. But, you know, I'm gonna do my damnedest to make this work. We got an Eternal Heart there, which is very beneficial. We're gonna run into some difficult rooms, there's no question about that. The freezing effect is an awesome addition here. Yeah, there was no question I was gonna take some damage there. Alright. Oh, and some more damage. I shouldn't be taking this much damage, though. We do have this Emperor card, but I'm gonna try to save it. This is a very valuable card for us right now. Book of Sin gives thank you. Every time Book of Sin gives us a Spirit Heart, an angel gets its wings. So I'm just gonna hang out over here. This should make me reasonably safe from the Brain Guys. Once the Brain Guys and their resulting creep are gone, we're just gonna drop down in here and do some easy shots against those guys from outside of their range. Money's off the charts right now. This is, yeah, I found pills, pill, which is not good. That's okay. If we find the boss room quickly, we didn't. Well, hopefully, yeah, the green guys can just destroy the gluttonies here. I do have crazy range. I'll give myself that in this situation. This guy's not dead yet? I actually hit him with one of the teeth from Brass Knuckles. Oh well, so we've reached the dead end. I have to go back into the room. I missed something. Obviously, we have to use Book of Sin. Picked up an extra bomb. Not the end or saving of the world, but it's something at the very least. And we're going to continue moving onwards here. So far, so good. I mean, it's not great, but we're surviving, and we haven't really lost that much health all told. Is this seriously like the first mob trap? Oh, that was terrible damage. Is this seriously the first mob trap room I've ever come across in this run so far, or have I just been skipping them? I don't think it's worth going into. We're going to use Book of Sin on this room, obviously. That extra penny is going to make all the difference moving forwards. Oh, man. So I'm thinking... Okay, I'm thinking we're probably not going to be able to keep this Eternal Heart. So the question remains, if we beat this floor, can we beat Mom's Heart with only 3 hearts in our current state? It's an interesting... Oh, Judgment, you could be my lucky star right now. Give me a health upgrade. Don't give me a spacebar item. Give me the compass. The compass would be beautiful. Combinate... Oh, it's not awful, but it's also not really that good at this point in the game. I'm not going to use Book of Sin because we didn't have any enemies to fight. We do have a secret room. Again, the secret room could probably not save us, but a 1-up or an Ankh would be very beneficial at this point in our lives. That Spirit Heart is incredibly valuable as well. If I can nurture this Eternal Heart until it actually becomes useful, that could be big as well. So this is going to be a nice hub for us, that secret room, in possibly finding the boss room, because we're not going to have to go through as much backtracking. Hopefully, anyway. Thank God this room doesn't contain the masks, because it would definitely be the end of my Eternal Heart, but it might also just be the end of my round in general. It might also be the end of my Emperor card as I, like, teleported to the boss. Like, oh, fuck this. Now, I'm really hoping for a Skolex fight. That's a speed up, I believe. Really hoping for a Skolex fight. Really not hoping for a bloat fight, basically. We're just going to use a bomb to kill this guy. Golden Chest is an easy open. And Book of Sin gives us 1 cent. There's our boss. I'm glad I didn't take that hub world just yet, anyway. And we've got Spectral Tears for this fight. Not that it matters, because it's basically over regardless. Okay. Utero 1. I think we're going to make it. Another Spirit Heart would be a beautiful upgrade, but instead we're just going to get cash. Money equals power would be sweet, but that's never going to happen. And it's the bloat. All right. It's the champion bloat. No less. We've got Spectral Tears rolling here. Is that good or bad? Well, it's not terrible. Could be worse. This is not going well. There goes our Eternal Heart. Maybe this bloat can't jump? No, it can jump. Just don't step on the creep, you piece of garbage. Okay. I'm going to have to... Oh, right. I totally forgot about that. Bloat could be our end here. To be honest with you, I kind of like that... Oh, why am I standing right next to him? Get next to him now. I kind of like that this bloat doesn't actually shoot out those shitty like long-range shots that always get me. I'm trying to like just drop the world's greatest bomb in here. Oh, we're fucked. I'm still alive for a brief moment at least. Keep it up. That was so close. Oh, don't stand sideways. Oh, fuck. Yes, kill. Oh, mommy, help me. Okay. No! I spent so long trying to dodge the end of that. Anyway, thank you to Novastato for that troll engine suggestion. That was pretty good. It ended up being a little weak, but that's not your fault. It's the fault of the item rooms and my own play. The item rooms basically give us nothing useful except for Spelunker's Hat and X-Ray Vision, which, of course, you know, combined are just an unstoppable combination. But in any case, that was a decently fun run. Had a lot of variety in it, in any case. As always, continue suggesting your challenge runs. I will do the ones I deem most appropriate and or entertaining. And as always, thank you guys for watching. I will see you next time.